find today is on conditional distributions and some problems on it. See, we already seen when two events A and B are given to you and B is already happened, what is the probability that A will happen? The probability is given as probability of A intersection B by P of B. This formula you have already seen, right? Where P of B should be greater than equals to 0. Okay. Now similarly, if I give like this, fx of x given B, B is an event, what is the condition that fx of x will happen? Okay. So this is same as probability of capital X less than equals to x given B, because we know fx of x is probability of capital X less than equals to x. So that only I am substituting here, and this is same as, see, this is in terms of P of A by B. So probability of capital X less than equals to x intersection B, so this is all in one bracket, divided by P of B. So this is called conditional distribution. Okay, now can you answer this one? What happens fx of minus infinite by b? What's the answer? Is there any intersection between those two? No, no. So answer is 0. What about fx of infinite by b? Answer is 1, because intersection is same as p of b even. Okay. Now probability of a less than x less than equals to b, I can write it as fx of b minus fx of a. This formula we have already seen. Okay. Now if I put a condition on this, probability of a less than x less than equals to b given event b. So I can write it as fx of b by capital B minus fx of a by capital B. So these on conditional distributions. Now on probability mass function, we know that probability of x means it's same as probability of x equals to x. Okay, so when I put condition here, that is probability of x, xk is a value and b is the event, it's already happened. So I can write it as probability of x equals to xk given b, and it's same as probability of x equals to xk intersection b, for all this you can put a bracket, divided by p of b. See, everything follows from this formula only, p of a by b. So almost all formulas are like similar. So this is conditional probability mass function. The formula is given this way. Now, when I talk about density function, so I know that fx of x is d by dx of fx of x. So if there is some condition, fx of x by b, I can take it as d by dx of fx of x by b. This is a conditional density function. Okay, so we will do some problems related to Rayleigh distribution now, on conditional distribution only. Okay, the problem is related to conditional distribution. So before that, what is Rayleigh? Okay, that we are going to see, or Rayleigh random variable or distribution. Okay, so fx of x is x by sigma square e power minus x square by 2 sigma square, where x is greater than 0 and it's 0 for x less than 0. The density function is given like this: x by sigma square e power minus x square by 2 sigma square for x greater than 0, and fx of x is given as 1 minus e power minus x square by 2 sigma square. 1 minus e power minus x square by 2 sigma square. Okay. And when I draw these two functions, density function as well as distribution functions, this is how it looks. Previous speech. Okay. So it's coming, going to become like this. Fx of x, and it starts at 0, okay? And this value is x. Now the distribution function will go something like this. This is capital Fx of x, and it starts at 0, okay? And max value here is 1. Okay, this is how the distribution function, and this is the density function, how it looks. This is the distribution function, how it looks for Rayleigh. Okay, now there is a question on it. The question says, I'm giving the data first, okay? So there is a parachuting sky diver is there, okay? Skydiver is there with parachute, and he has to fall on some target, okay? And that target is in circle, and see the divers are coming and falling on it, and they are fall mostly within the circle, and we want to measure the distance with respect to the center. We want to measure the distance, okay? And if I throw some random data on it, so it follows a Rayleigh distribution, okay? So what do you mean by that? Means, see, for example, if this is 0, right, the random value goes like this, right? So most of the things happens within half of this. That means most of the people will fall closer to this only compared to the ends. That's a mean. If I say Rayleigh distribution, means most of the divers will fall near to this origin compared to the end, okay? Because the probability is very, very less at the end, okay? As this is the x value, or this I can say the distance with respect to the center. Okay, that's a meaning. Now, and it's already given some data, that is, it follows a Rayleigh random variable with parameters given as sigma square. So sigma square is 100 here. See, only thing is, x is a value here, x is the value, and sigma square is the variance. I can take it as 100 here, sigma square. See, if these two things, if variance is not there, I can get this density function formula, okay? So this is what is given. Now question was, so diver will land within a radius of 10 meters from the center of the target. 10 meters with respect to center, okay? What is the probability of it? I want to find probability of capital X less than equals to 10. So this is same as what in terms of distribution function? It is same as fx of 10, no? The distribution of Rayleigh random variable, we know it. That is 1 minus e power minus sigma square by x square by sigma square, right? Yeah, minus x square by 2 sigma square. X square by 2 sigma square. So if I substitute it, 1 minus e power x is 10, so it's 100 by 2 into 100. So answer is going to be 0.393 approximately. Okay. Now the other question is, so this is the A part. The other question is this B part. We want to find the radius or the distance with respect to the center, R value, such that the probability is closer to e power minus 1. That is approximately 0.368. We want to find the R value so that the probability or distribution function, okay, overall at this R value will be equal to 0.368. So this is same as, so we want to find x greater than r, okay? We want to find x greater than r. So this is same as probability of x greater than r. It's same as 1 minus probability of x less than equals to r. And this will be equals to 1 minus fx of r. I can write like this. So this is same as 1 minus fx of r. I can write it as 1 minus e power minus x square by 2 sigma square, okay? So x square here is r by 200. And this will be equal to e power minus r square by 200, and this I have to approximate to e power minus 1. So from this I can say that r square by 200 should be equals to minus 1. So I can say r square is 200, r is root of 200, that is equals to 14.142 meters. Okay. Now continuation of the same question. See, the circle, whatever is there, okay, let's say this is around 50 meters. From here to here it is 50 meters, and damn sure that these people, the divers are going to fall or land on this place only. Okay, and it's damn sure 50 meters I am given, damn sure. Now that is damn sure means, what is the probability that again they are within less than 10 meters? Okay, so I am giving condition like probability of x less than equals to 10, given that damn sure they will be falling, landing within less than 50 meters. This is the probability we want to find out. So this is same as what? Fx of 10 given x less than 50, can I write? Yes, no? I can write like this, right? What is the intersection between these two? X less than equals to 10, intersection s less than equals to 50. Intersection is less than equals to 10 divided by fx of 50. Right, now the formula. Now this is same as 1 minus e power minus 100 by 200 divided by 1 minus e power minus 2500 by 200, approximately 0.393 it will come. So this is conditional distribution question. Okay, fine. So now we are going into the syllabus. See, first going with the syllabus, I'll give an example for you. For example, last class experiments we are taken with help of coins. Okay, like coin is first twice or thrice or single time or like that we are done. Okay, so that example only I'm going for that. Before that, I'll give one more example. For example, take a class. So class students, okay. See, now from this, I kept some exam and you got some marks, okay, for 50 marks. Okay, so if I note down that, I'm calling this M as a random variable. What is the range of M? 0 to 50. It can be any value between 0 to 50. And next thing I'm taking as weight of a student, I'm calling as W from the same class itself. So what is the range? It can be from 40 to 100, let's say approximately, okay? So 0 to 50 marks is a range here, and 40 to 100 kilos, okay? Kilos is a weight here. Similarly, if I talk about height of the student, what happens? If I call this random variable as h, so what happens? Height means, what is the range? I can take from 4 to 7 feet, for example. Okay, see, from the same class itself, I have taken three random variables. Okay, so when I'm talking about single case, it's single random variable. When I'm talking about two, it's called bi-random variable. When I'm talking about three, I call as three random variable. For example, now see, I'll put a question like this. I want the probability for M less than 25 marks. Okay, and student weight is less than 70 kgs and height is less than 5 feet. Is it possible for me to get this probability? Yes, no? So what is the meaning of comma here means? It's an intersection. I want less than 25 and I want less than 70 and I want less than 5 feet. It's an intersection. Okay, so like this I can frame this three random variable probabilities. Say probabilities are came to me means I see already random ranges or variable ranges are known to me. Okay, from that I can get random values, random variable distributions, probability mass functions, everything I can get. Okay, that's what we are going to see. Okay, so from the same class itself, is it possible for me to get some more random variables? Yes, no. For example, what I can say? Next one. So for example, if you say that which state you belongs to, okay? In India, which state you belongs to? There are some states, so range is fixed. And in that, everyone will pick one state, okay? So state, even if you take some other, like which color shirt you are wearing or which color dress you are wearing. So that also becomes one more random variable. See, from the same class itself, I can pick more and more random variables. So this is what you have to keep in mind when I'm discussing about next topics. If I say by random variable means I'm taking from the same experiment. Okay. Okay. So let's take this coin experiment. So two fake coins. So I have a random variable X, which says number of heads, and Y random variable says number of tails. So I have a sample space like head, head tile, tile head, and tile. Okay. What is the X value that takes here? Y value that takes here? X value will be 1, 0. What about here? 0, 1, 1, 2. What is the range of X? So range of X is same as range of Y, that is from 0 to 2. Yes, no? So I got the range. Now I want to get combined random variables, that is like combined range, okay? R X Y of X comma Y. See, if I X takes 0, what is the chance that Y will take? 2 only, na? There is no other chance for me. Combine together X and Y, the range of X, Y I am taking, two cases. If X is taking 0, Y has to take only 2. If X is taking 1, Y has to take 1. And if X takes 2, 0, there is a case. Only 3 cases are possible, that's it. So there is no like 2 comma 1 and 1 comma 2, it's not possible in the experiment. Except all the X range is from 0 to 2 and Y range is from 0 to 2. So the XY combination range is only 3 possible chances are here based on our experiment. Okay. Now what is the probability for this 0 comma 2? Or you answer this one. Okay. First, probability of capital X equals to 0 or probability X equals to 1 PX of 2. What's the answer? This is 0 is 1 by 4. 1 is 1 by 2. This is 1 by 2. This is same as PY of 0. This is same as PY of 1. Oh, this is 1 by 4, yeah. PY of 2. Is it correct? Probability of X equals to 0, it's same as 1 by 4. Y equals to 1 is 1 by 2. You got it. Now, what is the probability of 0 comma 2? 0 comma 2 means head is appeared 0 times, tile is appeared 2 times. What is the probability? 1 by 4. From the experiment, I can say now this is the only chance I get the outcome. What about this one? Probability 1 comma 1. 1 by 2. What is this probability? 1 by 4. See, individually, if you see, the properties are satisfied. That is, sum of all probabilities should be equal to 1. When you combine together also, you see that sum of probability should be equal to 1. So this is what is called as PXY of X comma Y. This is called probability mass function. Yes, no? So I am plotting X direction and Y direction. If X is 0 comma 0, no chance. 1, 2. This is X direction. And this is Y direction. So this is 1, this is 2. See, 0, 0, there is no chance. But 0, 2, I have a probability here, okay? So take it in Z direction. That means towards you, the probability here is 1 by 4. 1 comma 1, the probability here is 1 by 2. Here is 1 by 4. So this is the probability mass function, but the direction of amplitude is in Z. Okay, because X random variable, Y random variable, and we are taking this in Z direction. So 1 by 2 means it's coming very close to you compared to 1 by 4. Got it? So two random variables, what is the probability mass function? Okay, so now we'll go one by one related to two random variables, and this is the example. Okay, so first we will go with distribution functions. So I call this as joint distribution function. So fxy of x comma y, I write like this. See, in single random variable, fx of x is probability of capital X less than equals to x. This is what we have seen, single random variable distribution function. Now here, the probability of capital X less than equals to x comma capital Y less than equals to y. See, one more dimension is increased. And what comma stands for means it's an intersection. See, comma means intersection, please keep in mind, okay? Both has to be satisfied. Fine. Now let's say there is two events A and B. At A event I am calling as capital X less than equals to X, and AY I am calling as capital Y less than equals to Y. So if I say fxy of x comma y, means its meaning is P of A intersection B. Got it? Meaning is comma stands for intersection, P of A intersection B. So this is same as probability of x less than equals to x intersection y less than equals to y, or I can also write like probability of x less than equals to x comma y less than equals to y. Okay, now if A and B are independent, the two events are independent, what is the formula we have given? A intersection B, I can write it as P of A into P of B. This is the formula I said for two events to be independent. Now what happens? Fx or y of x comma y. So it's same as fx of x into fy of y. If x and y are independent, or I can say that A event and B events are independent, I can write like this. Okay, next properties of joint distribution. See, first property says that the distribution function is always between 0 to 1. And second one, if x1 is less than equals to x2 and y1 is less than equals to y2, then fxy of x1 comma y1 is less than equals to fxy of x2 comma y1 less than equals to fxy of x2 comma y2, and this is separate and this is separate. Fxy of x1 comma y1 is less than equals to fxy of x1 comma y2 less than equals to fxy of x2 comma y2. What this property says, that joint distribution function is also a non-decreasing function. Okay, it's also a non-decreasing function. Now third property says fxy of, say I'm writing directly, infinite comma infinite means what's the answer? 1. Okay, now fourth one, fxy of x comma minus infinite, what will be the answer? 0, because we don't have any intersection here. Okay, now fxy of minus infinite comma y is also 0. Okay, and we already seen this property, that is fxy of a plus comma y is same as fxy of a comma y, because it's a continuous function. Okay, now next property, probability of x1 less than capital X less than equals to x2 comma capital Y less than equals to y. Okay, see, in 1D case we have probability of a less than x less than equals to b, I can write it as what? Fx of b minus fx of a, I can write. See, here also same condition. Okay, so what I can write? Fx y of x2 comma y minus fx y of x1 comma y. Okay, so now other case, probability of capital X less than equals to X, Y1 less than Y, less than equals to Y2. Okay, I can write it as fxy of X comma Y2 minus fxy of X comma Y1. It's the same as 1D case, but we have one more dimension here to increase it. Okay. So one more new term comes here. It's called as marginal distribution. Okay. Or keep in mind, marginal means from 2D case, I want to get 1D case. Okay. That you keep it as a mind. Okay. For example, I want to get, that means given is fxy of x comma y. 2D case is given to you. I want to get 1D case. Okay. I want to get fx of x from it. So what I can do? Fxy of x comma infinite, if I say, it's same as fx of x. Yes, no. Now similarly, fy of y is same as fxy of infinite comma y. See, marginal distributions means from 2D case I am getting 1D case. Similarly, we have marginal probability mass function also, marginal density function also. That means what? From 2D marginal, from 2D probability mass function, I have to get single random variable probability mass function. Okay. So next thing, it's joint probability mass function. So joint probability mass function. Okay. See, in 1D case, what is the formula I have given is probability of X means it's same as probability capital X equals to X. This is in 1D case. Okay. So in 2D case, probability of XY, XI comma YJ is same as probability of X equals to XI comma Y equals to YJ. Where if I put comma means it's an intersection. Okay. Both has to be satisfied. So this is the definition for probability mass function, joint probability mass function. So what's the difference? From 1D case means one more dimension is increased, that's it. So if you understand those both basics, these are all very easy for you. So properties, so properties 0 less than pxy of xi comma yj, that means probability mass function will be always between 0 to 1. Then sum of all probabilities, sum of all probabilities will be equal to 1. Yes, no. This property also comes from single random variable only. That I have to add all probabilities means it will be 1. Like example I have given, no, this one. See, in this case what happens? If I sum up all probabilities, the answer is going to be 1. So the property has to be satisfied. Now, relationship between probability mass function and joint, okay? Joint probability mass function and joint distribution function, okay? So, I can write fxy of xi comma yj as summation x less than equals to xi summation y less than equals to yj pxy of xi comma yj. See, this is also same, similar to 1D case, but one more dimension is increased, so one more summation came. That's it. Okay. Now, what is marginal probability mass function means? Again, given for you, pxy of x comma y is given to you. From this, if you are asked to get what is px of x, and what is py of y, okay? So px of x, I can take it as summation all yj's pxy of xi comma yj. For example, this is xi. So I'm summing up all yj's. Similarly, p capital Y of yi means, see, this is same as capital Y equals to yi, okay? This is same as summation all xi's pxy of xi comma yj. So from 2D case, this is how you should get 1D case. Now next one, if x and y are independent, okay? If x and y are independent, I can write this joint probability mass function as individual marginal probability mass functions, multiplication of the individual marginal probability mass functions. See, I said comma is for intersection. See, P of A intersection B is P of A into P of B. Same formula only is going on for probability mass function. Okay. Now we'll see continuous case. So today this will be the last topic, continuous random variables. Okay, that is continuous two random variables. I call as joint probability density function. So when random variables are continuous, see examples whatever I have discussed is all discrete only, that coins and all. Okay, so continuous case means, for example, if I take height of you is measured in terms of length. Okay, if length I take it as a continuous, that means I can measure up to pico nanometers or whatever, maybe millimeters or centimeters or nanometers, micrometers. If I'm going further depth, I can take length as a continuous random variable. From the same class itself, if I take length as a height, okay, length, so that I can take it as one random variable. Then the other thing, what I can take, continuous. If I go with age is with respect to time, okay, time also, if I go with in terms of picoseconds or nanoseconds, so on, so much accurate, then only I can take time also is in continuous. For example, age and height, both I can take it as continuous. See, age, if for example you say 19 years or 19.3 months, like this. Further, if I go down 3 months, 3 days or 24 hours or whatever, maybe seconds, picoseconds also I can say. Like that, I'm saying that time also if I consider as a continuous case. Okay, that is example from the same class itself, if I take height and age. Height is nothing but length and this is nothing but time. See, from the same class itself, I can get two random variables which are continuous. So if this is the case, see, fxy of x comma y is given as dou square by dou x dou y fxy of x comma y. Okay, and inverse relationship, fxy of x comma y, I can take it as integral from minus infinite to x, integral from minus infinite to y, fxy of, I can take it as a comma b, dA dB. Okay, a and b are dummy variables. So relationship between distribution function and density function, inverse relationship here. Okay, now we will see the properties. So properties, see, always density function should be greater than or equals to 0, and integral minus infinite to infinite, integral minus infinite to infinite fxy of x comma y dx dy should be equals to 1. That means the area of this 2D density function should be equal to 1. It's same as in discrete case, summing up of all probability should be equal to 1, this meaning, okay, in discrete. Now probability of a less than x less than equals to b and probability of c less than y less than equals to d, I can write it as integral from c to d, integral from a to b, fxy of x comma y dx dy. See, since it's a continuous case, see, probability of a less than x less than equals to b and c less than y less than equals to d is same as probability of a less than equals to x less than b less than equals to b comma c less than y less than equals to d, and it's also same as probability of a less than equals to x less than b c less than equals to y less than d, and it's also same as probability of a less than x less than b c less than y less than d, because equal to will not work, right? At one particular value, the probability is 0. We already defined, no? For continuous case, probability of x equals to x means some x value means it's 0. So that's why for equal to, it's same as previous. Is this okay? Did you understand this one? We already given probability of capital X equals to X is 0 for continuous case always. At say one value we can't define because there are infinite random values present. Okay. Now marginal. So what do you mean by marginal here again? Marginal PDF I want. So what is that? Given is fxy of x comma y and you want to get individual case. Fx of x means I have to do integral with respect to what? Dy or dx? Dy, because I want all values of y. Okay. Now similarly, fy of y, I can take it as integral from minus infinite to infinite. Fxy of x comma y dx. So how to get individual density function from two or joint probability density function? That's called as marginal probability density functions. What happens if they are independent? X and Y are independent means? So independent X and Y, okay? I can write fxy of x comma y as fx of x into fy of y. Okay. So by this I'm stopping here.